everyone, this is Kaikasha. In this session you are going to learn journal knowledge. Okay, so all of you open your sunshine textbook page number 224. First chapter, classification of animals. What do you mean by classification, children? Classification means organizing things in a group. Okay, organizing things in a group according to their characteristics, okay, or features. So here animals, classification of animals you are going to learn. So animals are classified into two groups, that is invertebrates and vertebrates. Invertebrates means, invertebrates are the animals who don't have backbone, understand? And cockroach, spider are the examples of invertebrates. Vertebrates are the animals who have backbone. Animals who possess backbone, who have backbone. So there are different types of animals comes under vertebrates. So fish, reptiles, amphibians, birds, mammals. Okay, so fish, you all know that animals which live under water. Reptiles, and reptiles are the animals live on land also and in water. Example, crocodile, snake, lizard. Understand? Amphibians are the amphibians animals, like example frog. Frog is the example of amphibians. Birds, parrot, eagle, okay, are the examples of birds. Mammals means animals breathe air and give birth to babies. Example, lion, tiger, elephant, horse, cow, goat, etc. Even though human beings comes under mammals. So how animals are classified? Animals are classified into different groups or in different features. Okay, so animals are classified by their different features. So let us see some features of animals here. Mammals are covered with hair. So mammals are covered with hair. Example, elephant, cow, horse are covered with hair. The body is covered with hair. Then birds are covered with feathers. So the body of the birds are covered with feathers. Example, crow, sparrow, parrot. Then fish breathe under the water. Fish breathe under the water and have fins. Reptiles have scaly skin. So reptiles have scaly skin, like snake, lizard. Have you seen their skin? How they are, it is scaly. Understand? So now we have to go through the exercise. So place each animal from the box into the correct category. We have to place each animal from the box and put into the correct category. So here the different categories here, birds and mammals, reptiles and fish. We have to place the particular animals there. Birds. So in birds, hummingbird, woodpecker, duck. Mammals, elephant, lion, horse. Reptiles, snake, crocodile, lizard. Fish, tuna, goldfish, trout. So what comes under bird? Hummingbird, woodpecker, duck. Mammals, elephant, lion, horse. Reptiles, snake, crocodile, lizard. Fish, tuna, goldfish, trout. So in this way, classification of animal has done. So this is about the classification of animals. Let us move towards the next lesson, children. Animals in danger. So let us see. Man has been killing animals for his own use. Yes, man is killing animals for his own use, because we use leather, means we use skin of animals to make leather. With leather we use, we make shoes, bags, etc. So we use some animals skin, or in many other, for medicinal purpose also we use some animals. So some animals are becoming less now. So that is called animals in danger. So due to this, the number of animals is dropping, so becoming less. Some animals are lost forever. Means some animals are lost forever. Means they are not there now. Extinct means they are not there now. And some are about to get lost. Means endangered. So some are about to get lost. Means they are also going to die very soon, or they are going to be killed by somebody. Okay, very soon. So they are endangered. So here they have given some names of animals which are endangered. Endangered animals. Let us see. Bengal tiger. So Bengal tiger. Arctic fox. Arctic fox. Emu leopard. Emu leopard. Giant panda. Giant panda. Killer whale. Killer whale. Fur seal. Fur seal. Grizzly bear. Grizzly bear. So these animals are in danger now. Okay. So we have to protect animals. So this is about the animals in danger. Let's move towards the lesson number 3, endangered bird. In last lesson you have learned endangered animal. Now endangered bird. So birds are also endangered because they are also becoming less. Okay. Endangered birds. Endangered birds are those birds which are left very few in number. Means they are left few in number. They are becoming less now. Okay. Some types of cranes and eagles are examples of endangered birds. So cranes and eagles are examples of endangered birds. So children, here on page number 226 they have given you an activity. Okay. So you can see here a bird. So you have to color this endangered bird. It is called the spoon-billed sandpiper. So what is the name of the bird? Spoon-billed sandpiper. So you have to color this bird. Okay. So this is about the endangered bird. Let us move towards the next lesson. Lesson number 4. Vines. So what do you mean by vine? A vine is a climbing or a trailing plant. So vine is a climbing, means the stem of this plant needs support. They grow and spread on the ground. Trailing also known as plants which need supports and spread on the ground, and it's climb. Okay. Many plants like grapes, cucumber, bitter gourd, bottle gourd, etc. grow as vines. So vines are also known as creepers, means they need support. The stem of this plant needs support and they grow on the ground. They spread on the ground. So I think you have seen this bitter gourd, bottle gourd, cucumber, grapes. Okay, many people plant this type of plants in their homes. Just you have to put the seed in the ground, in the soil, and you can see in a few days the stem grows. Okay, and spreads all over on the ground, and they are called as creepers and climbing plant. Okay, so this is about the vine, and you here on page number 227, you can see on page number 227 they have given an activity. Have fun while coloring the grape vines below. So you have to color the grape vine. Understand? So this is about the vines. I hope you all understood all the lessons. So go through it once. Thank you.